I can't believe the girl thought that I was actually French.
Is this a better view? Shit. Bonjour from gay Paris.
I'm so early. I'm too early. It's like 9:30 and the thing doesn't open until 10. So I've got like 30 minutes to just hang about and figure out what to do with myself. Walking through. I'm in coach 10, which is just up here.
Guys, I have just got into my room literally just a second ago. You can see I've got all of my stuff here. This is a nice room. It's a bit bigger to what I thought it was going to be. Oh, this is so cute. They even gave me like a card and it says, "Dear Alice, we give you a warm welcome into the Russia Schwa Hotel. Have a great stay." I'm so excited. Oh, there's a fly. And they gave me some, I think these are mandolins. So cute. I'm going to eat those. I can't wait to film a room tour. I think I'm going to film a room tour now. So stay tuned to my channel for that. Oh my God, guys. Honestly, wow. But they don't have slippers and they don't have a robe. But I guess it's a good thing that I brought socks. Oh, the mini bar. But no, let me film a room tour. And what's that? Oh, okay, no. Let me film a room tour and then I'll come back. Also, quick time check. It is local time 3:30. I literally can't believe I'm here. This is so surreal. Really quickly, let's see what the view is. They said we'd have a courtyard view, but we don't. We do have a view of some Parisian buildings, which is nice. I already did some street mapping, so I'm kind of familiar-ish. But yeah, I want to get outside and explore Paris. I've just finished filming a room tour. I'm very impressed with how my makeup is looking. I'm also very hungry, so I'm trying to figure out what I want to do right now. It's also 6:30. It's 4:30. It's also 4:30. Jesus. There's this tower that I want to go and see. I can't remember what it's called, but there's a tower that I want to go to this evening. So I'm gonna book that now and then go to that. I think I'd want to go to that at like 8 p.m. I think. I don't know how late 8 p.m. is in terms of like getting back, but I'm gonna, you know, challenge myself to do some things. Is it Montparnasse, I think that's how you pronounce it. There's an option where you can get a glass of champagne or you can just go without the champagne. I think I might get a glass of champagne because when in Paris, baby. Someone was saying that you should go and see it when it's sunset because then you can see like it looks really pretty. So the sunset tonight is at 9:30. So I'm wondering if I maybe book for 9, see the sunset and then make my way back. I don't even know if it's like properly safe to come back at that time. Also because I'll probably get lost. I think, yeah, let's book for 9. The timing is what is kind of throwing me off because I don't want to go too late, but I want to like catch the sunset. I think that's kind of the thing that's gagging me a bit. But you know what? To be on the safe side, 8:30 is limited availability. No, I think to be on the safe side, let's go for 8:30. Or should we do 8 o'clock? Let's do 9. It is a bit late, but I'm also like, I want to like enjoy Paris. The last time I was in Paris, me and my friend did come like a midnight walk around Paris, and it was such a lovely thing to do. Even though there were the two of us, it was a bit safer. But I just need to. I'm an independent woman. Okay, done. Okay, let me get my card. I'm so excited. Let me add to wallet. Oh, it's 1 hour. Shit. I didn't realize it was for 1 hour, but that's good. I feel like that's good. Also, I'm not a finance person or anything like that, but if you have a HSBC account, you should definitely check out their money debit card. So this is what I'm using. Previously, I was using a Paxton card, which is also like another global card. Not the transaction fee, but you don't have to pay the conversion fee. You basically just pay in euros. So you preload the card with money. So literally every single thing that I've paid for from this hotel
to my car to take me from the station to here. I've booked my Uber to come and get me on Monday. I've just paid all that in euros on my global card because then I don't need to pay the transaction fees. The HSBC one is good because you just transfer money from your HSBC account into the account via the app. Like, it's super simple and you don't have to like fill out any extra forms or anything like that. But I'm not a finance person, but if you're looking for something that's kind of easy but you don't have to think about, then that is great. Caxton is also good. I was using Caxton for probably like 10 years or something, and I only switched to HSBC because I don't know why I switched to HSBC, to be honest. I think they just mentioned that they were doing a global card and I was like, oh, I'll try it out. But Caxton is really good as well. But anyway,
it is 6 o'clock. It's so funny because my laptop is an hour behind, and so I'm like not really sure what the time is, but it's 6 o'clock. I've actually found a restaurant that I want to go to for dinner. It's in the 14th, which is where the I don't know what it's called, but I booked in. The sun has just come out, so I'm really hoping that we'll see the sunset. And found this Korean restaurant called Dokkaebi 14. It looks really good. It's got lots of good reviews on it. It's about an hour away from here. I should actually Google map it real quick. It's like a 2-hour walk. Shit, I gotta get a move on. It's literally like 2 hours away. I know it's like a 2-hour round trip. It's like an hour and a half. Oh, do you know what? That's kind of doable. So anyway, so it's now 6 o'clock of the day. I'm not gonna touch up my makeup. I'm just gonna get changed and then we're gonna head out, take in the sights. And yeah, I'm really excited. This is so random and so impromptu, but then I also feel like I didn't come to Paris to stay in my hotel room. Anyway, so I'm gonna go get changed and then get going. It's an hour's walk. I'm excited. The only thing I'm not excited about is getting lost. I've already gotten lost once today. If you know me in real life, you know that me and directions. And I try really hard. Like, I don't like to say that I'm not good at things, because I think that just manifests in life. But me and directions, so I really do feel like I need to get a move on. We are ready to go. This is the outfit. Wish me luck. I literally hate how like easy this feels. Like, I literally feel like I live here. Maybe it's because I'm a London babe and like London and Paris kind of have their similarities. Well, I can't talk. So how you navigate one city, you kind of can navigate the other, but I feel so like this is so normal, but that makes people uncomfortable because obviously this is not normal. This is like the second time I've been to Paris, but I low-key love it. The only thing I don't love is that I'm wearing tights and it is so warm. I'm so tempted to take my tights off. I just need to think it might be cooler when I'm coming home. I just love how easy this feels. I literally feel like a Parisian babe. We're on the Pont de Carousel. It is so pretty. There's something about being like a tourist that I feel like you just feel so shameless. I'm like, oh, I don't care if people can see me. It's been such a lovely walk. But I feel like if you're like a Londoner or you live in a city that is a walkable one, then like quite naturally you're gonna find it easy. I think I've been walking for like, I've not even walked that long, they're only like half an hour. I think we should be at the restaurant in like 54 minutes, but it's so nice. I freaking love it. I hope this vlog isn't going to be too long, but I feel like it's going to be quite long. I literally can't believe I'm in Paris by myself. This is so crazy, but it feels so normal. I think I just said that. Honestly, I feel like I'm at home. Oh, I'm so excited. So we just had our first meal in France. It was really good. I would have ordered more, but I realized that by the time I got there, I just realized I need to get to the tower thing in like 20 minutes. And it's like a 20 minute walk. So I was like, I need to hurry up because you can only be like 15 minutes late. And in case I get lost, I want to give myself ample time to get there. So I only ordered like some kimbap, which was really good. Can't believe it's 9 o'clock and it's so light outside. So this is where we're going. Also, I have to say, not to toot my own horn, but for a girl who cannot read a map and who gets lost easily, I'm so surprised that I found the restaurant so easily. And like, yeah, we were walking for like an hour and a half, but honestly it was nice. And it was nice just to like see Paris and just kind of see it all. And there are like so many places that I wasn't even thinking of to go, but obviously we only have tomorrow and
Sunday to do all this shit, so I don't know. But anyway, I'm so excited to see Paris. Like, I can't wait to see it. I really want to see, like, all the views. I'm a sucker for a good view. I want to do everything. I want my cheeky glass of champagne because I've not had a drink in so long. So that'd be nice. Also got my, oh shit, got my Invisalign teeth out because I'm going to be drinking champagne in like the next bit of time. So that kind of should all add up for my 2 hours of teeth in my mouth. No, but can we take a moment? This makeup that I did this morning at like 7 a.m. is looking immaculate. Fucking love it. Anyway, yes, let me go and pay attention.
Wow.
We're just about to finish. I keep saying we. I'm just about to finish, so it's 10 to 10, and then we're gonna make the hour and a half long walk back to the hotel. I feel like it's gonna take like an hour, not an hour and a half. I'm quite fast at walking. I literally still can't believe that I came to Paris by myself. Literally such a beautiful evening. Also my makeup, this slaps. Oh, the Eiffel Tower is like shining its light. It's so nice. It's funny because it's literally like 10 p.m. like 10:15. No, like 10:20. Look at the Eiffel Tower, it's so cute. I think obviously because it is really touristy, so there are a bunch of tourists just walking around, / locals just walking around. Although I definitely will put my phone away because I don't want to get bugged. I'm literally just taking this whole thing in and it feels amazing. But now I promise that I'm going to put my phone away and just try not to get distracted because, yeah, I don't want to get mugged and I want to get home. I think we've got like another 49 minutes, like 45 minutes left. 46 minutes, amazing. So I feel like we can just get back to the hotel super fast. Also, I'm so hungry, so I'm gonna see if I can find like a supermarket or corner shop or something open so I can get like a bag of crisps or like a snack or something. I am starved. Guys, we made it back. I am so tired. I've outdone myself by my own standards. I've definitely outdone myself. I am exhausted. I don't know what tomorrow is gonna look like because realistically, I don't know how tired I'm gonna be tomorrow. Where's my water? I am so freaking thirsty. There's like a corner shop that's still open. So I just got some random, I actually hate this water so much. We used to have this on like school trips. But it's cold. In the cold, I'm so hot, first of all. I don't like my mustache. But anyway, I've outdone myself. I don't know what tomorrow's gonna look like. I feel like tomorrow, I'm gonna take it easy. Also, I literally love cookies so much. And wherever I go, I always have to try whatever cookies they have. And I feel they have these Grandino ones, which I've never seen or tried before. So I'm gonna eat those in bed while I think about all of my life choices. It is also 10 past 11. The maps on my phone said that we would get back here at like 11:15, but we actually got back here at like 11. But anyway, it is 1 a.m. I'm trying to get stuff from my phone onto my laptop, but it's not working. I'm also trying to figure out what tomorrow should look like. I want to go to the Rodin Museum. You can get a combined ticket for the Rodin Museum and the Dorsey. So I'm thinking of getting that, then that way on Sunday I can go to the Dorsey, and then I want to come back, rest, do some editing, and then I want to eat at Maggie's, which is the restaurant downstairs in the hotel, and then I want to go to Mercado, which is like the nightclub in the hotel. I can hear the music. I'm regretting taking off my makeup, but this evening was so much fun, and it was so fun just like walking around and like seeing all the different things. Like I really enjoyed that. It's so late. It's like 10 past 1. Oh, 1:11. Although it's weird because technically it's only like 10 past 12. So my brain is like, it's not that late. But I should go to bed. I don't know what time breakfast is, so I need to double check that. But our first day in Paris is complete. It feels so good, but also so surreal. Like, I can't believe we're here. I can't believe I'm actually here. Like, I actually came here. Like, that is very surreal. And it's funny because I guess in a way I thought I might feel a bit weird about being here by myself, but I don't feel any kind of way about being here by myself. So yeah, I'm excited about our first full day tomorrow. I think that'll be really fun. At least you can't believe I'm here.
But I love it, I love it, I love it. Anyway, guys, I'll see you in the morning. Bye. Good morning, guys. It's Saturday. It is 9:20. Breakfast is finishing at 10:30. So because I don't want to miss breakfast, I think I'm just going to brush my teeth, wash my face, do basic skincare, put on a random outfit, go down to breakfast, and then after breakfast, gonna shower, brush my teeth again, get dressed. After last night, where I was so hungry, I want to make sure that I don't miss breakfast. I've got breakfast included on my room plan, but ordinarily the breakfast buffet is €20, and looking at the menu, they've got a lot of stuff. But yeah, today's our first full day and I'm excited. Also, guys, it's like 21 degrees today and sunny, like I woke up and the sun was shining. But anyway, let's get ready because it is 9:20. Skincare. I know that I'm gonna have a shower, so everything that I'm putting on my neck is just gonna come off. I've got my tropic. I'm so sad because my Banish serum finished, so I don't have like a day serum. Oh, it is so surreal being here. I woke up this morning and it's like, as cliche as it sounds, I was really like, where am I? But I quickly collected myself. I can't go into bed so late last night. I think also the time difference has got me because I'm just like, what do you mean it's that late? I woke up and it was like 8:40 something, but it felt really early. So now it's 9:30, so I'm really just like, I don't want to miss breakfast. Also, because I've paid for it, I definitely don't want to miss breakfast. Part of me is like, oh, I should just do like room service. I think if I was staying for like an extra day, I would get room service, but I'm leaving on Monday. There's like a bunch of places I want to go to eat in and discover, but one place that I definitely do want to go to is Dongne Chicken. But I also want to go to the restaurant tonight, so maybe we could go to Dongne Chicken tomorrow and I can practice ordering food. But anyway, why am I waffling? I need to go down to breakfast. So, jeans. I said I wouldn't wear this top again, but I have to wear this. Nice. I've not done a city break in so long, and truth be told, like, I don't really do city breaks. So I'm so used to like breakfast just being in basically a bikini and a caftan, so it feels weird to actually have to like put on proper clothes. Also, it feels weird knowing that I'm gonna come back up after breakfast, have a shower, and then get changed, which feels kind of like a waste, but it's 9:37. This is us ready for dinner. This is us ready for breakfast. Wow. Even though we are unshowered, I should still make a bit of an effort with jewelry. So I think that for breakfast, we're gonna do these. And we're just gonna do like one individual index ring. I'm excited to do my makeup today because I've got some new makeup products I wanna try. I think I'm gonna take a book down with me. I wanna try not to be on my phone because, oh God, there are people who can pass. I think I wanna take a book with me because I want to not be on my phone so much. And I didn't read yesterday. Okay, so this is us. I feel too fresh-faced, but the bags out of my... Bag on my eyes. But anyway, let's go down to breakfast. Let's eat. I'm so hungry.
The lemon cake is amazing. One thing the French do well is dessert, so I don't know why I was surprised, but that was so good. Also, why is my hair everywhere? Let's try the croissant. I've not had a croissant in like 5 years. This is a good croissant. Tomorrow I definitely have to come down early enough so I can eat enough. Oh my God, guys, this is amazing.
We are just about to hit the road. This is the outfit for today. I've still not bought my tickets for the Rodin Museum, so we're just gonna turn up and see if we can get the combined Rodin and Dorsey ticket, because if that's the case, we can go to the Dorsey tomorrow. But yeah, let's go.
This red lip is gorgeous. I love my outfit today. It looks like your local. It's 1 o'clock. If you can see, it's like 1 o'clock and I was so stressed. Also, I need to stop vlogging and just like take in the city, but I feel like I just want to keep speaking because I've got so much stuff I want to say. But I was just thinking just now, last week, even yesterday morning, I was like, yeah, I'm gonna leave super early, like 11, so to have left practically at 1 p.m. I do feel a bit like, But at the same time, this trip is teaching me to just slow down and do shit in my own time and to just like not stress because the city's gonna be here. And I'm so glad that I came out now because I am stuffed. I'm full to the gills. Oh shit. I feel just so like good and like energized for today. And I like that. I like that it's like on my time. Like everything has been done on my time, which feels really nice as well. God, I'm literally so hot already. Yeah. But anyway, we are walking down the roads of Paris. I just love it. Honestly, I just love it. And it's nice to just like walk, even though I walk in London, but it's just nice to walk. If you need like a solo time, just by yourself, Paris is a great place to have some solo time. It's so funny because I kind of remember stuff from yesterday, like from yesterday evening. This feels really nice. So we're just like aimlessly wandering, and because I know that everything is pretty much in one straight line, so it's hard to get lost, even though you can still go down the wrong way. I'm like, where is this? Okay, I've gone down the wrong way. Right now we are on Place Vendôme. I feel so serene. I'm literally so lost in my thoughts. The only thing that brings me back to my thoughts is the GPS guy telling me which way to go. But other than that, I'm just like in a world of my own. It's so nice out here. I feel so relaxed. This is like the perfect way to spend a Saturday. Beautiful day. We are almost at the museum. Oh, it's been such a peaceful walk. I can't wait to come back here again. So I definitely feel like spring is like the best time to come, like May, because it's still busy, but it's like very quiet. Like this road is empty. That said, it is a Saturday, and I feel like Saturdays are usually quite quiet. Mate, I just, this is the life. This is the life indeed. We've made it to the Road to Museum, and I bought my joint ticket. Word to the wise, you can only get a joint ticket from the actual museum. So if you want to go to the Rodin and the Dorsey, kind of up for a reduced price, you should come to the museum. So it was 25 euros, which I think isn't bad because one single ticket to get into the Rodin is 14 euros. I think it's like 16 euros to get into the Dorsey, so you save like a couple of euros basically, which is really good. But yeah, let's go into the museum and have a walk about. I'm not really familiar with Rodin's work. Truth be told, I only found out about this museum because Lisa from Blackpink was here with her boyfriend a couple of weeks ago, and I saw the picture of the gardens and I was like, oh my god, the gardens look so nice. And so then I decided that I was gonna come here. But I can't say that I've never heard of Rodin, because I definitely have done, but not like properly. Like I couldn't have told you any of his work. Although having then researched him, I do know some of his work. Like there's The Thinking Man, there's The Walking Man. He's got a lot of, my rubbish fell. He has a lot of iconic work that you've definitely seen before, but you just wouldn't attribute it to him because, I don't know, well, I wouldn't. But it's been nice like, seeing all of his work and just like seeing all the stuff and nice to know the gallery. I feel like I've not been to a gallery in France, but it's really nice to just come to the country and see another gallery. I do want to see more of his work. So I think once I finish chatting with you guys, I'm going to walk around. Well, I'm walking through the gardens now, but I'm going to walk around some more of the gardens and look at more of his sculptures. He's got a lot that are out here. And fun fact, you might not know, the Rodin Museum was actually a hotel, but then they turned it into a museum, which is pretty cool. This place is massive, so I can see how this used to be a hotel. So pretty. This would be such a good like place to come to on a date as well. What's the time? So it's 10 to 4. Well, I can't tell the time. It's 10 to 4. I need to stop saying we because it's only me, but I feel like we're here together. But anyway, 10 to 4, I'm gonna make my way back to the hotel and just take in the sights, dream about my future, pretend that I'm a Parisian. So I will see you back at the hotel.
Why is there always a fly in here whenever I come in here? Also, my makeup, amazing. So I've just come back from my daily excursion. I've made a reservation at the restaurant downstairs called Maggie's. What I found is the best thing to do is when you have an idea to do something, you really have to just go ahead and do it. And this comes from the president of the Procrastination Society. Like, I feel like I'm president of Procrastinationville. Like, no one can procrastinate like I can procrastinate. I've got a long list of things that needs to be doing. So we've made a reservation for 8 p.m. I think that's good for me because it takes away all of my thinking. Like, I don't need to think about anything now. Also, I keep saying we, but I just mean me. It's a bad habit that I have. So what is the time? It is that time. We have now like 2 hours. 2 hours before I think I'm going to start getting ready for dinner. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to get changed. I'm so freaking hot. Get changed into some cozy clothes, start editing these videos, and then just veg out and do nothing until like 7, and then 7 p.m. I'm gonna start to get ready. Also, all of my nails have come off bar one, and on this hand bar one. Also went into Mango on my way back from the museum. Mango is so much cheaper in Paris. If you find yourself in Paris and you want to buy something from Mango, that's when you should buy it. I saw a blazer that I wanted to get that's like £80, but it's only €75.99. So I might get it, but I need to double check that it's the same one that I wanted to get. But anyway, let me get undressed and chill out. I'm so tired. I am running late for dinner. My reservation's at 8 and it is 8:03, so I need to run down. But this is what we're wearing to dinner. I feel like I'm taking everything with me. I'm taking my Longchamp pouch and my phone and my money that won't fit. Also gonna take my camera as well, but I'm just gonna keep it in my pocket. We're going all black, long flared jean with a little heel. I'm so nervous because even though I ate by myself yesterday for dinner, I just feel like it was a bit different. But now probably being in like a restaurant with other people, I'm a bit like, oh God, I'm so scared. But I've got my phone, I've got my battery pack, so I will be doing lots of scrolling, lots of reading, and yeah, wish me luck, guys. I'll see you down there.
We're at dinner alone. I've picked a table, a corner table, because I'm so shy, but here we are.
We have just come back from dinner. Look at this bed, nice and empty. This is why I can never Oh, the light is good here. This is why whenever I go out, I always have to make sure that my bed slash room or whatever is tidy, because nothing worse than coming back when you're super tired and you have to clean up. That's not for me, baby. That's not for me. Anyway, I feel like I should dress like this more. I cannot wait to get changed and take off my makeup. I've had this makeup on all day. I'm also curious to see how this mascara is going to come off, because this is a new mascara that I'm using today. This is the Pat McGrath, I don't even know what it's called, but it's a Pat McGrath mascara in the gold tube. Let me see if I can pop you up here. Would you believe, where's my phone, because I'm in disbelief. It is 11:11. And what time was my dinner reservation? My dinner reservation was at 8 p.m. So I've been eating dinner for the last 3 hours. I never knew I could eat that slowly. Tomorrow's gonna be a long day. Tomorrow's our last day. After last night, well, this morning, I went to bed literally at 2 a.m. I think I'm just a lot more conscious of going to bed super late. I don't wanna go to bed too late. And I know that I'm literally gonna go to bed in like 3 hours anyway. Tomorrow, like I said, it's gonna be quite a busy day. While I was at the Rodin Museum, I got a ticket to also go to the Dorsey Museum. So that's what we'll do tomorrow. That ticket is valid for like 3 months. I literally felt like Hagrid. Like, stick to your ticket, Harry. Stick to your ticket. I definitely felt like that. I was like, don't lose your ticket. Not that I would lose it, but the way I can't find my room key again, I'm like, stick to your ticket. Jesus, I ate a lot because the way my belly is imprinted with these jeans. Wow. But anyway. Oh my god. I can't get my shoe off. My camera's about to die. I can't get my shoe off. Oh my god. That took too long. But yeah, so I also was on TikTok earlier today while I was decompressing, and this woman was in Paris. What are the odds? And we're going to pharmacy tomorrow. I'm very excited about it. We're going to City Pharma. I do need to check that they're actually open tomorrow, because tomorrow is Sunday. And I don't know if it's like the UK where like lots of things are usually closed on a Sunday, even though technically now in the UK everything is still open on a Sunday. But I want to check, I need to check if it will be open on Sunday. If it's open, then we'll go tomorrow, and then we'll get some skincare bits. Not that I need skincare. So yeah, I'll bid you bonsoir, bonne nuit, and I will see you guys tomorrow. Good morning, gang. It is quarter to, what's the time? It's quarter to nine. Let's see what the weather's gonna be. I already know what I'm wearing today because I brought a limited amount of clothing. So it's 13 degrees outside today, highs of 20 degrees. It's mostly cloudy. It's supposed to rain today from 3 o'clock until like seven. Sunny in London today, but this is our last full day in Paris. Today we've got lots of fun things planned. We're going to the Dorsey this morning. I want to go to Mango to buy the blazer that I've had on my blazer wish list. I also had a thought yesterday. I want to go to Longchamp. Even if I don't buy anything, I still think just to go to Longchamp in Paris would be amazing. And I've never been to a Longchamp before. In Paris, obviously. So I think that'll be quite fun. I don't think I'm gonna buy anything, but still just be nice to check it out. Then I wanna go to City Pharma and maybe get a few bits. And then just to like wander around, see what's about, and then come back here. And then this evening I wanna go to Dongne Chicken for dinner and then just see what's about. I think probably end up heading to Dongne Chicken around like 9-ish. Hopefully it's not busy. I feel like that place is always busy. And then come back and then pack and then do the rest of it. So yeah, that is today's plan. So it's now 10 to 9. So that gives me enough time, almost like an hour. Like an hour, unlike yesterday, I'm going to shower before breakfast. So that after breakfast is a bit more like streamlined and I don't spend so much time in here. So yeah, good morning from the last full day in Paris. So this is the outfit for breakfast. Breakfast finishes in like 30 minutes. It's 10:05. Shit, I need to get me one. Just come back from breakfast. It is so, I keep saying it's so late, and I need to remember that there's no such thing as being late. Like, it is what it is. Where's the light good? It is 11, basically. It's 10:55. So right now what I'm gonna do is I'm going to clean my teeth, change my trays, change my Invisalign trays, put on some makeup, and then we're gonna head out. I'm so excited because I feel like today we're gonna experience a rainy day in Paris, and I am so freaking excited because I feel like we've experienced a really hot, warm day, like a mild day, a nice mild evening, and so we're gonna finally get to experience a rainy day. Also, I feel like there's something so like Parisian about a rainy day in Paris. My only downside is that I didn't bring my big umbrella, and I wish I brought a big umbrella because I just feel like a massive big black umbrella walking down the streets of rainy Paris, I'm like, is that not the most romantical Parisian thing you've ever envisioned in your entire life? I don't know, it is to me. But anyway, I want to leave, I'm gonna say in the next half an hour, which I think is a bit unrealistic, so I say I want to leave in the next hour, so by 12 we should be out pounding the pavement. And so let's get into the rest of the day. Also, breakfast is really good. I'm surprised at how much I like this breakfast. The croissants, or the croissants, as my dad used to call them, are so freaking good. Like, I'm so sad that today I only managed to get one because I was too slow, but at least I managed to get it. Also, the lemon cake, if you were ever at the hotel Brochechouart and you like lemon cake, you need to eat their lemon cake. It is so freaking good, and I just want to eat it all freaking day long because it is amazing. Literally tastes so good. Anyway, let me undo my teeth because we gotta go.
Ready to hit the road. This is the outfit of the day. Just a nice, simple, casual outfit. Comfy shoes, comfy jeans, and yeah, let's go. It's so funny thinking that I'm actually just walking through like the Oxford Street equivalent of France. I had this thought yesterday and it just makes me laugh. I want to go to the Putney parts of Paris, you know, or like the Shoreditch part of Paris. Like, what is the equivalent? Oh shit, this is scary. This is so fucking scary. Why is the river right there? I'm gonna fall in. This is definitely giving me an Elliot Bridge. This place is absolutely rammed, which I knew it would be because it's 1 o'clock. So I knew it would be rammed, but it's absolutely rammo. If you want to come here and it's like not so full, definitely come at like 9 when it first opens. Also, make sure that you have a ticket before you come. The queue outside was ridiculous, people that have tickets. So make sure that you bring that you have a ticket so you can just like skip the line, and you can get tickets with a time slot and without a time slot. Mine didn't have a time slot, but I could still just speed ahead. Okay. Whew. So, with that out of the way, let's get into the dossier. Oh, wow. I don't know what room I found myself in, but this room is crazy. Like, it's so grand, it's so ornate, it's like giving Versailles glamour. Wow, it's so pretty in here. Oh my god, it's literally so nice in here. Also, this makeup is definitely giving. It is 3:15. I swear I could spend the whole day here. There's so much that I've really glossed over and that I've not really been in to see. So a second trip to the Dorsey is definitely in order, but I still want to go to City Pharma and I still want to go to Mango and I want to go to Longchamp as well. I'm not sure when everything closes, but I'm imagining like 6, so that leaves like 3 hours to get to a bunch of different places. So I think City Pharma is only like 10 minutes from here, so I feel like I might spend another like 15-20 minutes in here and then head out. We are on our way now to City Pharma. We should be there in like 20 minutes. It's supposed to rain. Oh my god, no, this queue is still... Listen guys, if you want to come to the Dorsey, you want to make sure that you have a ticket. I'm going to take a quick snap of what it looks like. The queue is insane, so if you want to come here, make sure that you have a ticket, is all I'm going to say. It will save you so much time, and yeah. Anyway, so we should be City Pharma in 17 minutes. I'm excited. I imagine that the store is going to be quite busy because it is 3:30 on a Sunday. Also, it's like a tourist hotspot. If you're into like skincare makeup, well, mostly skincare and like French skincare, it is like a tourist hotspot. So I imagine that it's going to be quite busy. And you kind of, oh, there's a pharmacy here. I kind of feel like you... Let's go into this one real quick. I'm in this random pharmacy that is up the road from the Dorsey, and they have my quarterly sunscreen for €15. I feel like it's like £20 in the UK. We're gonna get one of these for sure. So the funny thing just happened. I just got some skincare. I'm like, do I even need to go to City Pharma? But we're going to go to City Pharma just to say that we've been to City Pharma. And I've heard it's like, well, I saw on Google Maps, it's like a massive building. And there's this girl that I watched her TikTok yesterday, and she was talking about going upstairs. And I think any time a shop has an upstairs, it's a shop that's worth going into. So we're going to go into that. I did buy some stuff. I bought a sunscreen because it was €14. And I just checked Cult Beauty, it's £25, but this was like £14.90. Like, what an absolute bargain. Fuck. Here we go. Am I on the right path? Yeah, so obviously I have to do that. And then I also bought the Caudalie Aveeno Perfect Dark Spot Correcting Serum. I have such a love-hate relationship with that serum, but somehow I always buy it. I feel like I buy that serum like once or twice a year, even though I love it, but I also hate it at the same time. Am I going in the right direction? I need to cross the road. I'm like too distracted. But yeah, so I bought that serum, which is so funny because I was going to write a blog post about serums and I was going to make a video about serums. So it's actually come at the perfect time because we were here yesterday when we went to the Rodin Museum. So anyway, got some skincare. I think City Pharma is more for novelty reasons than for actual like buying reasons. What was I saying? Yeah, so I think City Pharma is just more for posterity. I'm on the wrong fucking road. Where am I going? I'm literally going down the wrong road. Okay, let me go down another road. Also guys, this is a real flex in my eyes. The amount of people that have stopped me to ask me for directions. If that is not the biggest compliment, then I don't know what it is, because obviously I look like a local. I look like I'm French, because not even French, Parisian, born and bred, because why else have two people today stopped and asked me for directions? Like, I don't understand it. I don't get it, but I fucking love it, because it just signals to me that low-key, this is who I should have been this whole time. Okay. Okay. I feel like we're in the right direction. I really can't like walk and talk and everything at the same time because I cannot multitask. And actually multitasking is a myth, a side note. I feel like I need to cross the road. but I think we're going in the right direction now, which is the biggest thing, and it is 3:39. Also, this is such a random side note, and I never talk about this kind of stuff on the channel, but something I really think about being in, I think I go in the wrong direction, but anyway, I always think about being in the right place at the right time. One of my like affirmations that I've been saying to myself for the last couple of months, actually for almost a year, is that I am always in the right place at the right time. And I think when you get stopped for directions, I think that really reaffirms that you're literally always in the right place at the right time. Even obviously these people could have asked anyone for directions, but the fact that you were there at that time to be asked for directions, and there have been so many times that people have asked me for directions and I've given them the direction, and it's like, wow, if I hadn't been there, which is kind of egotistical at the same time as being kind of like cosmic, karmic, cosmic, I don't know. But I'm also like, I love that I was asked for directions and that this reaffirms to me that yes, I am always in the right place at the right time. I see the pharmacy up ahead. Kind of walked this route on Friday, so it's like interesting seeing it first of all in the daytime, but then also from a reverse angle. Wow. We lucked out in the pharmacy, and I've learnt my lesson that I should just wait to go to City Pharma. I'm literally kicking myself because what I bought in the other pharmacy that was near the museum, I bought the two things separately. So separately that was like 60 euros, but in City Pharma they were selling like a double pack for like 40, I can't remember, it's like 42 euros, so I literally lost 20 euros, but that's fine, at least I will know for next time. But the products, they have so many products. I would definitely say if you do want to go to City Pharma, come with a shopping list that you know what you want to get, and like at least if you don't know what brands, because they have like lots of brands and lots of brands I hadn't heard of, so even if you don't know about like the brands, if you come with like a shopping list at least of products and things that you're looking for, it will help you kind of work through what you want. There are three floors as well, so lots of stock. Also, it was really packed and really busy, so I would say to go there like really early when it opens or really late when it shuts. Beautiful. Okay, so right now we are on our way to Longchamp. I want to see if I can get a new bag, just like a small one, because my current small bag is not looking good. I've just bought a new Longchamp bag to replace my old one. So I want to look for Cezanne because I think the actual standalone store is closed. So I'm going to go upstairs, see if we can find the store. I kind of want to get a white t-shirt and then we're going to head out. I'm doing a mad scramble to try and remember all the places that I said that I wanted to go to, which is funny because I also have a list on my phone of all the places that I want to go to, so I should just look at that list. But anyway, we are in Le Bon Marche. Let me see if there's like names. What floor are we on? Okay, we're on the right floor. I actually found Cezanne, but I didn't see anything that I liked, and I think it's time for us to go. I was just in Farm Rio, and the sales associate was so sweet. She was speaking to me in French. I feel like this is a sign, guys, that I have to move here. Well, no, first of all, I have to learn French, because the amount of people that keep talking to me in French, I'm like, I don't understand. No, parle anglais. Wait, no, that means I can't speak English. Non parle français. Parle. But anyway. Anyway, I think we should go. It's like 4 o'clock. No, it's 5 o'clock, shit. It's even later than I thought. It is 5 o'clock, but I've got my goods. So I feel like we've done a good job. But anyway, I think it's time for us to go. Actually, I wanted to go to Mango. I don't know if I can go to Mango. Let me see what the directions to Mango are. One thing about Paris is the stink, but it's not a smelly place. But sometimes you'll walk and then you'll just get like a waft of the most disgusting thing ever. It's just so random. Anyway, we're now walking. We should get to Mango in 30 minutes, which is fine because Mango is on route home. I think it's the same one that we saw yesterday. I can't believe how lucky I've got with the weather today. Actually, even today, this whole weekend, like, it was supposed to rain. I think it did rain, but I was in the museum, so I completely missed the rain. And I think it was also supposed to rain yesterday, but it didn't rain at all yesterday. And it was so sunny. Definitely could have come in a cute sundress, but I didn't really bring anything like that. But the weather's been so nice. Oh wow, so this is where City Farmer is. We've kind of, wow. Not me literally just tripping, so I'm just gonna go straight ahead. It's so nice exploring and discovering new places. I hope I remember this when I come again next time. A Big Bang restaurant. We are on Pont-Neuf, the infamous bridge. Walking over the second Pont Neuf. I am so tired. I'm honestly thinking to myself, do I really need to get this blazer? I know I love a bargain, but I'm so fucking tired. I'm gonna have to admit defeat today, because also it is 20 to 6. I need to lie down for at least an hour. So snooze you lose, Alice. I should have gone yesterday. I am plum tuckered out. Just made it back to the room. Guys, truth be told, I actually just want to spend the evening in the hotel and literally not do a single thing because I am so tired. My feet hurt because I had a stone in my shoe and it was so small and it was just hurting my toes, and now my feet hurt. But it is our last official night in Paris, and I did promise myself that I would go to Dongne Chicken, so we're gonna go to Dongne Chicken. However, to almost make up for how fucking tired I am and how sore my feet are, we are changing today's evening outfit. The girl needs to be in trainers. I was gonna wear these cute boots, but I'm like, your girl is not wearing those. Instead, I'm gonna wear my dusty, crusty Pumas because my feet need all the cushioning that they can get. And because it's so fucking hot and sunny today, I'm gonna have my legs out. Anyway, I need to, what's the time? It's 6:45. I'm not gonna leave until 8 p.m. at the earliest. So that gives me like an hour to just do nothing. Also, a moment for the makeup, and I'm filming on my phone right now. It's giving, how do you make your makeup last all day? I'm not gonna lie, I'm not mad at it, I fucking love it. Also, I got a compliment. I think getting compliments is such a flex, but also I got a compliment in French. I can't believe the girl thought that I was actually French. I fucking love it. I love that I give off the vibe. But anyway, so yes, I know I look cute, makeup looks amazing, so we're gonna keep this makeup as always for when we go out later on. But guys, I need to lay down. It is 8 p.m. It's 8:06. I need to get ready for our last night in Paris. I keep saying this. I think at this point of the vlog, I don't even know how many times I've said this, but take a shot every time I say that I want to go to Dongne Chicken. So I want to go to Dongne Chicken. I'm about to get dressed. It's about 30 minutes from here. I'm going to wear trainers, going to be super comfortable today because I think bar the 20 minutes I was sat down in the Dorsey, I've been on my feet all day. So the outfit of the nuit is this reformation dress that I wear to death, and then we're gonna wear this blazer over the top. I kind of want to go for a walk after dinner and just like walk about. Oh my god, look at the sunset. The sun, I don't know if the sunset, but the way the sun is coming in through the window, so chic. I feel like everything about Paris is so chic. I don't know if that's just because I'm a tourist. I think it probably is just because I'm a tourist, but as a Londoner, not that there's similarities, but I think as a Londoner, you kind of, what's the word? It's like you kind of don't feel anything when people wax lyric about how great London is and London's this and London's that. You kind of just like,
I can't think of what the word is, but you just kind of go like numb to all of that stuff because it's like, oh, well, I live here, whatever. Even though I do have to say that London is the greatest city, but anyway. But then I think going to another country, another city that's equally ass, like up there ass your own city, it is like, oh, I kind of see like what the tourists mean when they say that the city's so beautiful. But Paris is genuinely such a beautiful city, and every single thing about it is so like chic. It's almost cliche that it is as chic and as gorgeous as it is. Can I just pop you on there? Will you fall? The buildings look so chic, like even the font of like the road signs, and like even like the road name placards, so chic, so freaking chic. So anyway, let's get ready to leave. Dongne Chicken closes at 10:30. The food looks so good. And I was looking at their menu yesterday, so I know what I want to get. Anyway, let's get dressed. The one thing I did not anticipate was Paris being this warm. And I get that it is May, and May time is kind of warm, but it's so warm. And then with the blazer again, I wasn't gonna bring this bag, but I kind of, but no. Today, for the first time, I'm gonna take my Longchamp bag. This is the small Le Plage. I should just take the brand new one, but I'm like, no, I won't do that. Gonna be so weird, like actually being able to carry every single thing that I need in this bag, because I've not been able to do that. This Strathbury bag doesn't actually fit a whole lot, even though I've made it fit a whole lot. You can kind of see it's keeping its shape. This is such an amazing bag, and I do feel like I don't like telling you or people to buy things. However, if you've had this bag on your wish list and you are looking for an excuse, a reason, a sign even from the universe, then this is your sign, because this bag is amazing. It's such a great day bag. It's a good evening bag. You can take it literally all across the city. It doesn't fit a lot, yet at the same time, it fits so much. So even like today, I had all this stuff in my bag, plus I also had my battery pack. I had my mascara in there. I had so much stuff in here. I had my headphones, I had my phone, I had my phone cable in here. I had so much stuff in here, and it fits a whole lot of stuff, but not too much stuff. So you need to be mindful about it, because also sometimes the bag won't close if it's too full, but the bag did so good. Anyway, because I'm just jibber jabbering and I do need to leave, I'm gonna pack up because I cannot come back to a messy room, a messy bed, a messy anything. So I literally always have to tidy up before I go out. Also, while I'm here, this bag has so much crap in it. But I'm gonna take this bag nonetheless, because whatever. Put my passport in here. I'm gonna bring that. This bag, honestly. Bring my lipstick and my mirror so I can check my reflection. Bring my mascara. Also gonna bring my Invisalign container, obviously. I think that's everything. And then headphones and hand cream. I'm actually cream my hands. Do my legs a bit. Cool beans. This way. Gonna bring my umbrella. I'm a London girl after all. My bag is so heavy. It's full of absolute crap. No, this is too heavy. I think it's my battery pack that's made this thing so freaking heavy. Okay, that's that. No, I think we're just gonna go with a simple classic hoop that you just can't beat. Nice, very nice. Can I bring my book? This is also The Courage to Be Disliked. This is my sister's book. She bought this last year. It's very interesting. It does make you think about things. I'm not even that far into the book, but it's already got me thinking about how I show up in the world and kind of how I've conditioned myself to think a certain way. I don't agree with everything so far that I've read, but I see the sense in it. Okay, I feel like we're nearly ready to go. After all of that faffing and baffing, nearly ready. Oh, this feels so nice. I've got all my bits. This is what we're working with. Okay, wish me luck. Let's go and see what we can see.
We should be there in 15 minutes. We are finished with dinner. We're going to take the long way back. I'm literally not following the map right now. I'm just gonna trust my wits. Dinner was so good. If you like Korean food and you find yourself, oh, what is this? I'm so easily distracted. Oh wow, this is basically the National Art History Museum. Okay, well, when we come to Paris again in a couple more months, we will come and see this place. That would have been a great place to go and see, especially as someone who loves an art gallery. I'm just like, well, I really missed a trick with that one, but that is okay because Paris isn't going anywhere. But what was I saying before I got so distracted? Yes, if you like Korean food and you're in Paris, you really do have to try out Dongne Chicken. If you have other like Korean restaurant recommendations, please do let me know. And oh, do you know, I think I should go down this way, but I want to see this monument. Anyway, keep getting distracted. Yes, if you like Korean food, check out Dongne Chicken. If you have other Korean food recommendations, let me know. Or any other restaurant recommendations, let me know. So that when I come again next time, I can go and see them. There are so many like restaurants and stuff around that I didn't get a chance to see. I am definitely living the life. Ooh, I can't believe this is my last night. What a great weekend it's been. Honestly, literally such a great weekend. It's about 10 p.m. So when we get back in, we're gonna pack, we'll finish packing, and then just gonna finish packing really, and then go to bed. I just need to double check my Uber that's coming tomorrow. That'll be another thing that we're doing for the first time, is getting in an Uber in a foreign country by myself. Random thought that I had while I was eating. Being in Paris by myself for 3 days, I could do this for a week, 2 weeks, a month. It's like just so freeing. Shit. I'm like addicted to spending time by myself, which cannot be a good thing. Okay, but now I'm going to actually look at a map because who knows where the fuck I am. I want to go past this place, but I think I've gone past it. We have made it back. Oh, I feel so sad. I feel so sad. I feel so sad. Where can I put you down? Hopefully you guys don't fall. But my back, I think all of the walking that I've done today, like my back is killing me. Also, tonight's outfit was a win. Obsessed with tonight's outfit. It's such a simple outfit. This was like the perfect final night outfit. Perfecto. I've just spoken to the front desk because I thought I'd lost my room key, which I actually hadn't lost my room key. It turns out that the cleaners, if you're staying at the hotel Rochechouart, the cleaners will take your room key if you leave it in the slot, which I did, which I probably should not have done. But what can you do? Is this a better view? I broke my camera. My camera is broken. Do you see that? What a way to remember this trip, by breaking my camera. Can you hear that? Can you see that? It's 10 to 11. I need to finish packing. I already packed up like 80% of my stuff, but I need to finish packing up the rest. I need to take off my makeup, and then I need to offload all of my content from my phone and my camera onto my laptop. And then we're gonna go to bed, and hopefully, fingers crossed, we can do all of that by 12. It's 10 to 11, so we've got like an hour to do all of that, because knowing me, I then need another hour before I can go to bed. Oh shit, let me lock the door, because I completely forgot to lock the door. So yes, so lots of stuff to do tonight. Day three is done. Also, this makeup, can we get into it? You can't really see it so much because it's dark, but it's giving. Oh my god, I haven't actually seen this on. I'm gonna plug it in. You can tell that I'm procrastinating, because why am I suddenly like, oh, let me turn on the light? Wow, that makes such a difference. So that's what this looks like. So anyway, had an amazing last night. Food was great, nice to walk around. And it's also funny because where I was walking, we had actually
I actually walked there early today when I was coming back to the hotel, so it was nice to see it like at night and kind of feel more familiar with it. I'm so proud of myself for coming out here. When I think back and reflect on it, I am so proud of myself coming out here. I've had the best weekend. It's been so much fun. I feel like I've discovered a bit more about myself, which has been fun. I feel like I'm such a different person to when I came, which sounds so over the top and very dramatic and like really, but I really do feel like I'm such a different person to who I was like 3 days ago. And this is what everyone who's ever traveled by themselves, and I've questioned them about it, this is what they all say. There is really nothing quite like traveling by yourself. It's such an experience. Obviously, I'm only saying this just because I've done it myself. I'm such a hypocrite, but I honestly feel like if you can, like, traveling by yourself is something that you have got to do. And I think even if you just go for like one weekend, you don't even need to do like a proper like thing. Even if you just do like one day, like a day trip somewhere just by yourself, the change is immense. I love it. Obviously, if you don't like your own company, you may struggle a bit, but if you love your own company, then I don't know why you wouldn't enjoy traveling alone. The only issue is eating alone, but now that I've officially eaten by myself five times if I include breakfast, 6 times will be tomorrow, I feel like I love it. Another tangent. I recently finished watching Dinner Mate. It's a K-drama on Amazon Prime. And the lead character, Doya? Anyway, she was saying that she likes to eat alone because she can eat at her own pace. And then funny enough, just before I came out, I was watching a Dear Jerry vlog and she was talking about how she likes to eat by herself because she gets to savor the taste of food. And one, first of all, she was promoting this like Louvre Loewe's product something, and the girl in Dongne Chicken was wearing a jacket from the same thing, and I was like, what are the odds? Like, literally the universe is throwing signs at me left, right and center that I'm always in the right place at the right time. But anyway, what was I saying? Yes, all of that to say, it's been so nice and freeing to just eat alone. I think that was the main thing that I was really scared about, was eating by myself. And now that I've done it, I'm like, not gonna lie, but it's nice. Obviously, nothing beats having a chin wag with my sisters, and you cannot beat that. But there's something about eating alone, and it's just you. And it's funny because I was on my phone for a bit, but I really wasn't even on my phone that much. I was just thinking and eating the food, but I was thinking about the food. And I'm just like, ugh, like honestly, eating alone, and you just, oh, but I'm clearly just saying all of this. I'm on a high horse because I'm so proud of myself for coming out here and having done this whole thing by myself. Ah, I'm so proud. Anyway, guys, I've got shit to do, so I will see you in the morning. Bonne nuit. I was going to watch YouTube, but I thought I would just look at the TV what was on because I love to watch TV in hotels. Criminal Minds, but French Criminal Minds. And now we have to watch it. I wanted to watch a YouTube video, but we're watching Criminal Minds, and I know this episode, so I don't care. They can't understand what they're saying because I literally know what happens in the episode. But oh my god, Criminal Minds! And if you know me, you know that Criminal Minds is in my top three shows. I think it's like Criminal Minds, Scandal. I can't think of what the third one is, but Criminal Minds is like my top one or two, with Scandal. Like, Criminal Minds? Jesus, I used to skip school to watch Criminal Minds, which tells you all you need to know. But anyway, good night, guys. What perfect way to end the weekend, watching Criminal Minds in French in bed with my laptop. Beautiful. Oh my god, Amelie, speak of the devil. It's the time. 8:10. I'm gonna just quickly check my my Uber's coming today, 11:26. Fiston is my driver. 29 euros, 30 euros basically. It's still cheaper than the car service that the hotel were gonna provide. And I just thought, you know what, to round off the experience, let's just get an Uber, because I've never actually gotten an Uber in a foreign country before, so I thought that could be a fun thing to do. My camera's still broken. I literally can't remember it, my camera yesterday. We are finally ready for breakfast. I got so distracted. I had the TV on and then I was just watching TV and I was getting into the French culture. I got too distracted. But anyway, this is what we're wearing to breakfast. Jeans, I've got Uniqlo Heat Tech vest on because I don't want to wear a jumper and I don't have any other clothes to wear. And then I'm gonna put on some trainers. And I've got these cute earrings in, just a small hoop. But yeah, breakfast finishes at 10. It is like 9. I think it's like 9:15. So we're gonna head down, eat some breakfast. Checkout is at 11. So I realized that I need to be back up here by like 10:30 at the latest. I wanna have like a leisurely breakfast. I talk too much. For someone who is very quiet and doesn't talk a lot, I actually talk way too much and I have way too much to say, because tell me why I'm done a lot quicker because I'm not filming, because I'm not jibber jabbering. Like, someone needs to explain that to me. Anyway, looking very fresh face. Shit. 9:22. I really do have to get a move on. Okay, 9:22. Okay, let's go to breakfast. What am I taking for breakfast? I'm gonna take my book and my phone. Oh, cannot forget my Invisalign case. I always forget my Invisalign case, but I cannot forget that. Back from breakfast. I need to be strict with myself because I keep not being strict with myself and then I overrun on time. Need to finish packing. I'm actually fully packed. I just need to rejudge my suitcase because somehow I don't know how I fit everything into my suitcase when I came. So I need to figure that out. Make sure the wardrobe is empty. I just have my coat in there, which I will wear, even though it feels like it's too warm to wear a coat. The bathroom is pretty empty. I just need to brush my teeth and like pack away my water. Suitcase is also needing doing, but I reckon that we can be done in 50 minutes, not even 50, like 45 minutes. I'm pretty sure. I just need to not faff. And then I also need to do my makeup. How fun. So let's tie up the hair so I can do my teeth, do some makeup, finish packing. So let me put on a timer because a timer is the best way to keep me accountable. 25 minutes, we are a go. 10 minutes left. I didn't bring the dust bag, so we are wrapping this baby up in my t-shirt. The timer has gone off. It's been 25 minutes. It's now 20 to 11. So I've got a timer on for 15 minutes. Still need to do my makeup. Shit. How did we do this? I've got my handbag, my carry-on. This one in here. Tripod, do some lip balm. This is the Fresh Rose Soft Petal Soft Lip Cream. Really nice. Let's do a light bit of makeup and then I need to actually know. Let me actually try and figure out how to pack my shoes in here. Okay. Beautiful. I made a mountain out of the molehill for the fun. Suitcase is done. I love that I didn't have a ribbon, so I just had to tie some tissue. My sister said that's very on brand for me. So this is what the rest of the room is looking like. I still need to do my makeup. So I'm just gonna like move stuff off the bed. We've got 9 minutes. Let me do some makeup for the millionth time. Actually, I also need to put my AirTag. Such a great investment. Okay, so now we're gonna do makeup, finally. And then we'll be ready to pack up the rest, final lot of my stuff. The next time you see me, I'll look different. My timer has just gone off. I'm happy to say that I'm so close to finishing. Oh, the makeup looks so good. So close to finishing packing. It is officially 11:01. My receipts. Cool beans. We are nearly ready. I need like 2 more minutes. Oh, my eye cream. Shit. Okay, well, I forgot to pack my eye cream, so I guess that will come with me. Everything else though, I feel like is okay. Jumper. Whoa. If only I'd had those reflexes yesterday when my camera fell. I'm gonna take these with me also, they're like covered in makeup. Cool beans.
So,
boobs. I don't like how you can see my socks.
Checking out is always such a mad rush.
Am I bleeding? Oh shit, I literally...
Okay, anyway, no time to waste because my car is going to be here in like 20 minutes. So yeah, we are making our way downtown. Let's go.
It's gonna be so fun watching back and laughing at my pronunciation. Up to London. Like Filch said, it's best to have your wits about you to navigate such a place by yourself.
People are saying that the Eurostar is hard to navigate for your first time, but I think it's quite easy. I am stood in the queue to check in. We're so early, but hopefully it will pay off because it's not even 12 yet and my train is in an hour.
We have made it through. That was so quick. It's like not even 12 yet, so we've got like another hour to go, but we are all through. I know that the internet says to arrive super early, but to be fair, it was a bit touch and go. There were some parts where there was quite a bit of a queue, but for the most part, I could have definitely left a bit later. The paranoia of travelling just means that you get to the train station 3 hours early because you never know what's going to happen.